Hey everybody, it's Christy with Fisher Fitness and Kidding Around Yoga. So I am here, I know that we've got holiday breaks coming up for our kids, and I know that I'm looking for stuff to just keep my kids active during the holidays. So this is paper plate activities, okay? I went to the grocery store and I bought a package of paper plates. Cheap paper plates, these are the uncoated white paper plates. For $1.79 for 100 of them, okay? And I'm gonna give you 10 different activities, games that you can play with paper plates for $1.79. Okay, you ready? Here we go, I'm gonna break these down. All right, game number one is called Drop the Cookie. This works great if you've got a large group, but you know, it's fine for a family of four or whatever. So split the group into two, give one half of the group, each person gets a plate, we're gonna call this cookie. The other half does not have a cookie. And then go, you know, someplace where you have a little space, maybe your yard, and start running around. And if you want to try and tag the person who has the cookie, if you tag them, you say, drop the cookie. They have to drop it, you pick it up, and you run away, and you try and keep the cookie. Everybody wants the cookie. So this is going to continue on, and the people are going to be switching back and forth and back and forth. Keeps everybody running and on their toes. All right, game number two is called Ups and Downs. So split your group into two. So if you're a family of four, two and two. So one group is ups, the other group is downs. Take a whole bunch of paper plates, scatter them all around your room or your yard, put half of them facing up, half of them facing down. Set a timer for like 2 minutes. So the ups group is gonna try and turn all the paper plates so they're facing up. The downs group, of course, will try and turn them all so they're facing down. At the end of the 2 minutes, whoever has the most in the proper position is the winning team. All right, game number three, paper plate ring toss. All right, so all you're gonna do for this one is get a paper plate and take a paper towel tube to the plate, okay? Take paper towel tube, take the other plate, cut a big circle in it, all right, and you very simply do a little ring toss. All right, try and toss it and get, oh, I didn't make it that time. You can make this more active by saying you have to do like 5 jumping jacks before you toss it. Maybe if you don't make it, you have a penalty of push-ups or something like that. Ring toss. All right, game number four is paper plate race. Oh my gosh, so fun. Each person in the race gets 2 plates, all right? And this is kind of like the floor is lava, okay? The way you do this is you've got your 2 plates, you set one plate down, you step on it, take another plate, set it down, step to that plate, turn back, reach back, grab this one, set it down, and you continue on all the way down to the finish line, and obviously the person who makes it there first is the winner, but you can only stay on your plates, you can't touch the floor. Alrighty, paper plate tennis! Alright, this is super fun. Take a paper plate, tape something to the back of it. This happens to be a popsicle stick, but you could use a regular stick from your backyard, you could use a pencil, whatever, just tape that, and this becomes your racket. Then, if you've got a balloon kicking around your house, by all means, use that and just kind of tap it, keep it up in the air, but you can use just a little wadded up piece of paper. This becomes your ball, and then you're just using your racket to see if you can keep it up in the air. Woo, that's really fun. And you could even tap it back and forth to people between each other if you want. Paper plate tennis. All right, game number six, paper plate colors and numbers. All right, what you're gonna need is you're gonna need 36 paper plates. So take 6 of them and color them red, or use a red marker, and you're gonna number them 1 through 6. Take 6 plates and do that same thing with orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple. So you've got all of those. Then you take 2 dice, and if you don't have these from some game kicking around your house, you can print one out. You can make your own little cubes and number them, that's fine. So roll one of them, and that is your color. So if it's 2, it's gonna be orange. Roll the other one, and that's the number you have to find. So if it's 5, you say, okay, everybody, orange 5. So all those plates that you colored and numbered, they're scattered all around your room or your yard or wherever it is you're playing, and then it becomes a race to see who can find the orange 5. Okay, and then whoever does, maybe they get to roll the next 2 dice and figure out what it is. Perfect game for kiddos who are working on colors and numbers and things like that, but honestly, everybody has a great time with that game. So that's colors and numbers. All right, game number 7 is the toss game. So take some paper plates, write in big, you know, numbers, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and then you get your little crumpled up piece of paper or a beanbag, and you toss it, and then you try to see how many points you can get. So each person like takes turns tossing it, and 50 points, I did good on that one. All right, so that's the paper plate, just a toss game. Okay, the next one is the letter lock. Oh, this is so cool. So take a paper plate and write the letters, write the alphabet all the way around the edge. Cut in between each letter. Take a walk with your family and see if you can find these letters on signs, on, you know, license plates, anything like that. So if you find, you know, if you find the letter A, then you just fold it down and then you see what other letters you can find, and then they have to look and, you know, fold down the letters as they find different letters. This would work great in the car. Make one of these for each of your kids, hand them back, and then as you're driving around, they can be looking outside at signs and the license plates and seeing if they can find all the letters of the alphabet. All right, so that is the letter walk. Okay, game number 9, paper plate ABCs. So 26 plates, write the alphabet, A, B, C, on each plate, write a letter on each plate. Take those plates, scatter them around the room face down. And then you have a race. So somebody is the caller and they say, okay, go find letter S. So everybody has to run around, turn the plates over and look, see if it's the right letter. If it's not, they turn it down and then they have to go on to the next one and keep checking until they find the correct letter. And then they come back and then whoever finds it first gets to be the next caller. All right, and then finally, paper plate ice skate, super fun. So whoever's playing this game gets two paper plates. They take those plates, they put them under the feet. By the way, this works best in bare feet. And then you just have races as if you're ice skating, right? So your feet have to stay on the paper plates as you go around the room and see, you know, see who can make it the quickest with their paper plate ice skates. Okay. So that is 10 games that you can play for a $1.79 pack of 100 paper plates. So I hope that makes sense. If you have questions about any of those games, feel free to shoot me a message. But let's keep our families moving. Let's keep our families active and just connect and have a great time this holiday season. So I wish you all the very best. Peace.